So after you've cut out your the base timber for your jig, we're gonna route out these channels. Like I said, the distance between the blade and the fence needs to be 67, 68 millimeters. That'll give you a really nice, clean, flush edge where those intersection bits meet with the edge of the piece of timber. So you can just set that distance to the fence, and then the height is just gonna be set by using a piece of T-track to actually place up against the blade, and then use a square to make sure that the blade is just ever so slightly higher than the T-track. That will be less than half a mil. It's just really so that you know that these T-tracks are gonna be sitting flush, if not slightly under the surface of the timber. And so I find just having it like a quarter of a mil higher than the T-track itself will give you the correct measurements. So once you've set the fence and the height, you're just gonna need to run it through on all three sides. Remember that we are routing the top face, not the bottom, as I did on my first cut because I wasn't thinking. So you're gonna do three passes on the top face. They will look very much like this. There's nothing really to it. If you don't have a router table and you wanted to do this with your hand router, it would be the same process. You just need to set up a fence of some sort to get a really nice straight line. It is very important that it is straight and that the depth is all consistent. I'm using a 19 mil straight bit, and that matches this T-track perfectly. Just for your information, the depth of these holes is approximately 9.5 or 10 mil. I'm not exactly sure. I haven't checked it more accurately because I've always just sized it directly to the T-track. So that's the process for routing out these. Then you're going to install these intersection bits. You can just screw them directly in, and then you'll measure the additional lengths of T-track that you need, and you can screw them in. And that's the first part of building this jig done.